Hello and welcome to today's lesson here at Investio. Today we're going to talk about how to separate the stock from the company. Most people believe that the stock and the company are the same thing and therefore the stock price is relevant to the company. This is not true actually, and today we're going to debunk why that is. Firstly, they are not the same. Stock prices don't always align with how the company does. This is because they are based upon predictions. For example, revenue announcements, world events. When a company's earnings report for Q1 is released, for example, it was predicted that the company would earn $1.7 billion in revenue. But the company just fell short by earning $1.68 billion. This will caused the price to drop because investors expected the company to do better and now they're worried about the company's future. Expectations and perception plays a big role in how the stock price is made or calculated. You can put it however you would like to. The same goes for announcements. If Ford announces it bought the Bugatti division of Volkswagen, as a hypothetical, the share price of Ford would go through the roof, obviously. However, if they announce that they have decided to let go of some workers, the share price will fall. It's about how the company looks to the outside world, its earnings and perceptions. Expectations, perceptions have a big correlation. Moving on. How do you prepare for this? Firstly, you must understand the company. You cannot invest in something you do not understand. So if you invest in PayPal, you must know that PayPal is a payment processing company and the revenue they collect is based upon what companies pay them to use them as a payment service. And they also have other payment services that they bought, such as iSettle. You should never invest in something you don't understand. You should monitor the company's earnings reports for all quarters. This is very important to do that. You should also check all of the announcements to the press on their website, and you should study what investors predict about earnings generated. You should also be mindful about investors' attitude towards the stock. Do they believe it's bullish or bearish? Bullish means that it can go through the roof and it's going up, or bearish means that it's going down. When it's bullish, you have a lot of demand and people are buying the stock and the morale is high. When it's bearish, a lot of people are dumping the stock to get the price to fall down, they're short selling. A lot of this is going on. Do they also believe that the company is being run poorly? Is it time for a change of leadership? Did a CEO with a good track record lead the company? All these things should be monitored and checked regularly. Now, what you need to do is use a value approach. Do not base your investments on one factor. Most people base their investments on one factor, and that is the stock price. And this is not good, because the stock is not the company, as Jeff Bezos said. Although the performances of a stock and its business tend to correlate over the long haul, in the short run they can move in the opposite directions. You should use the principles of value investing. They matter. You should look at the business as a whole. How are Amazon doing? Are they scaling? Are they hiring more people? Are new divisions being made? Are they acquiring new businesses such as Ring? The stock really rose when they acquired Ring for over $1 billion. This is what you need to do. Use value investing. Now, what is value investing? Well, first we're going to go through the pros and the cons of value investing. The pros is that it's low risk, high potential for high rewards, and it's very simple to learn. Now, when it comes to the cons, it's valuable companies are often hidden. Therefore, it requires much in-depth research, and unless you can really know what you're looking for, then it's going to be hard. But don't worry, in a future lesson I'm going to teach you exactly how to identify companies and study the stock charts. And another con is patience is key when it comes to investing. I've already told you this in the previous lesson. Patience is one of the most important things when it comes to investing. Money is attracted to patient people, as Warren Buffett said. Now, value investing can be explained in simple terms as paying less than the fair value of a stock to earn good returns when the stock gets back to its normal or fair value. This concept was first introduced by Benjamin Graham. It involves finding those stocks or companies that are believed to be undervalued or available at a discounted rates. This is based on the various financial parameter. This style is closely related to the concept of margin safety. It can be defined as the difference between intrinsic value of a stock and its market price. The intrinsic value is what the stock is really worth. For example, I believe that PayPal is worth about $250 in reality, but it's down at $93. It protects the investor from errors involved in judgment of fair value. It also provides a good return opportunity and minimizes the risk. Value investing can provide good profits once the market inevitably re-evaluates the stock and raises its price to the fair value. Now, this was the end of today's lesson, and next lesson we're going to talk about how to analyze stocks, what specifically to look for. There are three things that I want you to look at. But thank you for attending this lesson, and hopefully you have a better understanding of what separates a stock from the company. Thank you.